That's so cool.
So again, we got most of the team.
Yeah, we did get some. It's usually like we. I don't think it's possible to have every team.
No, it's streamed every game, but that,
yeah, well, definitely not.
Nah, I can't do that.
I think it was like decided amongst like the players a bit ago during like, I don't know, the first. I think it was the first draft where like people would much rather have like a bunch of off-stream games and have double elimination, get a chance to play more, versus like, you know, like. I get setting up for the event and like, you know, single limb could go pretty long as well, but just having the players, you know, get to play more often, giving that second chance from losers.
Yeah, definitely some things to consider there. We got Ryota and Yoru Sensei throwing down this loser semifinal. Stroke the egg roll and flower division. Yoru opening for flower division.
Yoru opening strong as well. Look at the life lead.
Yeah, massive right now, 6XL. Not punishable, not in this patch, but we don't have to confirm.
Yeah, no great confirm there for Ryota. It's going to get DP'd in that gap. Clean from Yoru Sensei.
Mm-hmm. Run up in the low. Yoru still starting up very aggressively. Excellent jump, but not able to get a jump in punish.
Oh, nice. Using the float. Very aggressively.
Still gauge.
Nice.
Good block on that overhead. 6L. Lead into full pickup here. Very short though, because we didn't get the close medium.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh my god! Nah. That was so perfectly timed from Ryota.
Yeah, somehow able to jump that. Yeah, it was only a light starter though, so the damage not as high as it could have been, but still we take it.
Nice.
What a shimmy.
That was disgusting. Block me, you'll get the kill. No resources.
Alright, plus some block. Brave counter to steal the turn back. And now Yoru Sensei out of Brave counters. However, with that full SBA gauge,
that could have been a punish. Ryota. That's it! Oh, pops!
No!
Got hit by the pod. Into the launch, and Yoru Sensei takes the first game of the set.
And a professional to the end, spending the Super Skybound art to get the kill on Ryota. Mm-hmm. Those life totals with the Brave Points being gone. Could have had a funny opportunity to go into the combo of self-destruct just for the fans, but kill's a kill, win's a win, and do what you practice.
Yeah, exactly. But Ryota did have a chance there. They did jump over the pod. Yes. But did not get the punish in time. So unfortunate. And is going to lose the game for it.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yeah, just that butterfly effect.
Yeah, exactly. But Yoru still staying strong. Clean 2-0. As we start this first set. Okay, looks like we're getting Plasma coming up.
Vegeta versus 2B.
All right, that's gonna be the Vegeta coming up from Plasma.
Even victory, battle one.
We haven't seen a lot of Vegeta tonight. I feel like he used to be a very popular character.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Plasma's been the only representative of that character in tonight's bracket. While the character did see some buffs to the 5U, the change to their Vorpal Blade and no longer having a wall bounce means that a lot of the mid-screen to corner routing for Vegeta has been toned down. So, you know, some give and take for the character. Still in a good spot, I'd argue.
Yeah, absolutely. Just not super, super strong, you know, because of that corner carry nerf, but still very, very good. Oh, no bait. We do it again.
That's crazy. Yoru just running through the gauntlet. High, low.
Oh, we're going to spend. Raging
Strike to extend. Yeah, yeah. Restock the breakpoint, too. Attacking on damage.
Excellent. Over a shimmy. Not going to find anything. We're staying strong on the defense. Oh,
then you try to run up and properly throw tech. It works out. JU cross-up will be blocked. Yoru Sensei spends the breakpoint. Does not want to give Plasma any momentum.
Okay.
Getting up.
No, wow. Just immediate sweep after blocking? You're crazy.
Battle two.
Like, if you got a frame drop there, you actually die.
Right? I mean, but hey, sometimes you just gotta make that gamble.
Wow.
DP's coming through too. Big jump here. Nice combo. Plasma, oh, yeah. Not. I think they might have been close enough to the corner to get something there, but I don't know. The height did look a little tricky, so he definitely had a pickup there in the old version of the game. So.
Absolutely. Seeing the nerfs at play. Backdash gonna get caught by that DP.
Scoop him.
Cancel out.
Get off of me. 2M will frame trap. 5U will punish.
Wait, does that work? Okay.
Nope.
That's... Honestly, I respect it. Like, I wish that worked. That was kind of cool, yeah, but I wish it worked.
A lot of just supers, a little too slow on startup, and interacting with projectiles, not favorable for all of them, so...
Mm-hmm. Oh my god. You are reaching your sensei. Taking out two already.
Again, on a hot streak right now, and with play like this, it makes you wonder how the hell did Flower Division get sent to losers in the first place.
Like, they seem so strong right now. But hey, it's all about how you close, right? Mm-hmm. These sets going down to the wire, it's all about the closer. Looks like we're going to be getting Stumi for a Stroke the Egg Roll coming up. All right, maybe the Versusia versus 2B? Yo, the DLC battle?
Okay.
Very cool, very cool.
Yeah, we will see how this one pans out. Both characters with strong full screen options.
Versusia versus 2B.
One of them's definitely a lot more mobile.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I don't know how well that that double jump is going to work against Versusia. Like, she's so tall, and then all of her stuff goes, like, full screen.
Believe in victory.
Yeah, yeah, true. Might be one of the few characters out there, actually.
My god.
What the hell am I reading? Kill Venice.
I spot dodge? Yeah, gonna use that to move in. Immediate guard cancel, though. Your sensei wants to run some offense.
Yep, looping this. Only a single break point left. Now has to regenerate through offense. Nice spot there from Stumi. He's going to catch the jump. And his overheads are doing some wonderful dividends. Looks for another reversal. After all, your sensei have full bar. Can threaten a DP. Plus on block. Brave counter spent again. Yoro down to a single point.
Nice confirm. Auto combo into SBA. The classic.
Dash cancel there. Yoru, throw gets teched. Air to air goes their way. Stumi in a rough spot. Throw won't kill, but strikes will.
Oh my god. Like, when will it not work? Every time.
It's just, yeah, people gotta change up their habits, right? There's something fundamentally human about wanting to tech a throw.
Indeed. And something about Yoru's sensei just conditioning them to throw. Counter. I actually get the side swap. Was not ready. And nice routing. Get the safe jump. Oh my god. What you can do, I can do better. And we gotta spend the meter. That's all your brave points gone. No, still have one left. But it's not in a good situation. This doesn't work. What the work?
Oh, you were right, then you were wrong!
So Gita sucks. Is this the conclusion? That Gita sucks? Or is that Versusia's broken?
All right, you know, either way you want to spend it. Nice, well, there it is, right? Using that skill of Versusia to contest the jump in. We get the clash sequence here. Stumi just stands there in place, didn't really have another follow-up to it. Yoru Sensei, down to barely more than
the
a pixel.
The whip
with the 5 heavy!
A clean sweep for your sensei. All
right. Yeah, that is right, Ring Text. That's right. Gita used to have that.
Oh, Gita lost projectile invul, and I see.
I remember now, yeah.
Oh, that's a big nerf, actually. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I recall it now. I've going through every character, Like, some information is stuck and other has just lost, because, like, I know a little thing about everybody now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, your sensei looking so clean. Taking the 3-0 clean sweep to start off the set. Let's go. I think, was that the first pick for... Yeah, that is the first round pick for Flower Division.
Yeah. So Yoru Sensei with the 3-0. And now we're going to see Rock come out with our second Soras of the night. Mm-hmm. Seika will once again return with the Zeta.
Team Captain is here. Oh, no confirm. Still gets the throw. Alright, BC out.
Yeah, very early showing from Captain as well. So Rock choosing to probably rely on other characters. Like,
oh my god!
Probably like Blue Pro.
Wait, that was sick. That armored up and then able to block the follow up. Oh my god!
Oh, yeah. No. So I think Seika's using that OS that's been posted very recently today. So for y'all that don't know, this is some tech posted out by I Am Gandito. And funnily enough, they use Zeta. As an example of it. You do a jump in on the opponent, which you can do some very specific setups for it, which is pretty universal. You can do a jump in normal, and then with a series of inputs, you'll be able to block a true reversal, like any DP, as well as use a counter option, if your character has that counter option, to beat out a Brave counter. So, very specific set of inputs, some very few characters have it. And probably right there again, Seika going for it there, and with Rock just going for the mash, Seika just blocks.
I didn't get that time. Oh my god, I got hit by that. I don't know how Rock blocked that.
Mm-hmm.
You got some neutral? Got some footsies?
Ben.
Oh, here's the install.
Ultimate at machismo.
Oh, that was so good. Oh
trying to go
my
for
god.
What a reaction counter as well, but it's minimal damage. No, the second swing of that DB catches. Rock, though, will be finished off as Seika plunges forward, eliminating the team captain of Flower Division.
That was so good from Seika. The reactions, all that, using the ult parry to stop the dash punch. Very smart. Team very well-versed in that matchup, for sure. As we have Dr. Pepperman coming up with the Bilal.
Oh man, we had soda earlier, and now we have specific name branding.
There's a lot of food names in the FGC.
A lot of food names tonight, man. Believe in victory. You're right. We're going to see the 23 flavors of the Lion mix up. Oh no, you got way too close.
As a Bilal main myself, I do think that this matchup is very Bilal favored. Just the frame data and his normals, and just the range can play out versus Zeta. Very favored. And the fact that you can also parry the projectile on reaction for a punish every time.
Oh yeah. So Zeta's a little scared about throwing out her full screen lasers.
Oh,
going for that, but there it is again. We've seen this before from Seika, right? Using these dive kicks to call out the run and throw attempts, and Dr. Pepperman can be eating a grip of damage.
Oh no, BC late! That is so unfortunate. But Seika will take that in stride. Battle
two. Lotteye's Gardevoir. You can always make the argument that, you know, the first Dr. Pepperman was so good, they had to make a sequel. Dr. Pepperman 2 awaits.
Imagine just taking someone else's name and naming yourself 2. Like, what if I just name myself Leffen 2?
Leffen 2.0. I mean, listen, either people go, yo, he really is the sequel, or it's like, nah, it's still in beta. Oh, it's a terrible version.
That's
you
got
to embrace that meme. Dr. Pepperman Zero. Yeah, you know, Hot Eyes.
Oh, wait,
actually,
that's actually
Diet Dr. Pepperman.
Diet Dr. Pepperman, as Dr. Pepperman has died to Seika.
I mean, what else is a diet but dying with a T?
That was bars, holy shit.
You say bars, that's a Garfield strip joke,
There's
bro.
No fucking way that's from Garfield.
There is joke. I mean, no, Garfield's talking about, hey, John's put me on a diet. We all know what a diet is, right? It's die with a T. That's what it is. I literally hit you with Garfield. You called it bars.
Okay, but Garfield do be spitting, maybe.
Yo, that was, honestly, that is the best Garfield joke. I'm not going to cap.
That's actually heat. I'm stealing that.
I that is a joke from a comic strip I read 15 some odd years ago. That's the one Garfield joke that lives in my brain rent free.
I mean, but, shit, it's kind of hard.
Like, that goes kind of hard. That.
It's pretty memorable. All right.
It's a good quote. It's genuinely a good quote. The one thing I will give credit for before, you know, Garfield has become this monstrosity that is. Y'all, if you got time, check out Super Eye Patch's Wolf video and what the internet did to Garfield. Mind-opening thing.
Not my boy Garfield. All right. Lucy coming in with another Versusia.
Yo, so many Versusias. This is orange. What character does this remind me of?
Is this supposed to be a reference?
I don't know, like, I'm just getting a vibe of where have I seen, like, orange hair like this, and my brain went, Hollow Ichigo, one of his forms, like, nah, that's not the thing. First thing I thought of, but now I can't unsee it. The rest of the color scheme ain't wrong.
It's Garfield.
Yeah, it's Garfield.
Wait, does that punish?
Yeah, no, this...
Oh, my God.
Nice. We definitely could have got more than a back throw there, but...
Yeah.
They could just take a simple one.
And they could also try to complete the clean sweep as well.
Yeah, DL site. It's like when he had that hollow transformation against Ukiyora. You know, it's that hair. The horns kind of help. The horns do kind of help. But again, the rest of the colors are kind of wrong.
Are we throwing out the full screen move? Immediate sweep on wake up?
Brave Counter Wars, 1, 2, 3. This is what Granblue has become. Are you happy, Psygames?
Fukuhara's vision. Yeah, that's definitely dead. Lucy, take that first round.
Cinematic needed. This is good.
I think that super gets cinematic from anywhere. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it does. It's a cool little feature of the game. Like, I'm torn on it. Like, on the one end, it's nice where it's like, okay, we don't have to sit through the whole cinematic.
Yeah.
Right? To see the end of the game. But at the same time, like, if that shit happened in Street Fighter 6, I'd be like, man, oh, I wanted to see that animation, dog. Like, that's such a cool looking super. You know what I mean? Like,
and then there's me playing DNF Duel where there's like 20 second super animations every time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, it's super, that has to be like the right length, you know? Like if super goes on too long, it's like, nah, this is a terrible mistake. Like Bardock level 3, you know, all that OG meme curse of your Dragon Ball when the game had that drink to it.
Did I get enough of Bardock level 3? Oh my god.
I mean, no, they didn't. Yeah, they didn't though. They refuse to give him any meaningful buffs. It's crazy. They keep buffing him and he's still trash.
Where's my goat?
Even crazier still, if you gave him all of his old tools, he wouldn't be top tier in this version of the game.
I imagine, with all the characters that's been added since him.
Yeah, right? Even, like, bro, like, they still refuse to give him, like, full self-combo EX moves. You know, like, you gotta spend extra resources to combo off your shit. It breaks my damn heart. Lucy, though, in a really good position here, but Seika with a dive kick yet again.
Yo, pre-patch?
This probably would have killed.
Pre-patch
this kill! Yeah! We were saying the same thing!
Pre-patch that kill! Alright, Lucy gonna take it. And he takes out Seika. Puts Fire Division in the lead.
Yeah. The loser's dream run. Starting to look pretty good here for them. So Lucy going to be staying on for Rock's team of Flower Division. You still have, I believe, Starlet, Merp, Nothing, Griminal Activity, and Lupro that still need to play. But for... I'm looking at the captain's names because, like, I got the names, the order backwards.
Yeah, Stroke the Egg Roll.
We got lost, yeah.
Here we got Antiquarian coming up. What have we not seen? I haven't seen Fumbler, Krylaws, BC.
No. Fumbler was. Oh, no. I'm thinking of the previous.
Set. Yeah, last set was Fumbler.
Yeah, that's the problem. Yeah, no Fumbler out yet. Ryota open. Bisou hasn't come out to play yet. We've seen Plasma. We've seen Seika. Antiquarian's coming up. So there's still plenty of opportunities here. Antiquarian. Yo, the map. All right, damn.
Now we're in that corner. My God. Lucy
just demonstrating the potency of this, and one of those rare instances where you're able to actually consistently, you know, get the punish on a brave counter when you spot dodge. So preemptive, and the timing has to line up. Honestly, I wish in the next patch they do make that counterplay consistent to brave.
Yeah, that was one of my wishes for this patch, but I think they want to keep it strong for some reason at this point.
Well, as long as they've had it, like. Yeah, as long as they've had it, they've made Brave Counter a very strong tool. And I think some of that is the fact that you only get three in a game. Not only that, too, like, it's competing with the other uses of the Brave Point system, right, with the Raging Strikes in particular. Yeah, you can get a refunded point when you use a super, but, you know, Raging Strike, Raging Chain, it's with the OSs that are in place with the game, right, like, it's always competing with that offensive capability, and their whole idea, too, is like, well, you don't want to spam it, right? Otherwise, as you get lower on the system, you take more damage. So, I don't know.
That's their balance philosophy, but, like, we've seen their balance philosophy, and I don't agree with it.
Yeah, no, like, it's definitely too... There needs to be some elements of a counterplay.
Yeah. Not having counterplay to a defensive mechanic does not feel well. Like, it does not, like, when playing, well, it doesn't feel good.
Yeah, it doesn't feel good. But that being said, in this patch, they've given more character-specific counterplay to it. Right? Onre is able to cancel into this counter in a block string and parry it. And then he just punishes you for Brave Countering. You got Catalina Lightwall that's able to deal with it. Zeta and Grant, right? Like, there's a lot of this. I'm going to leave a gap in my pressure sequence to then, that will then let me maintain my turn on offense if you don't press it, or just get a full punish on you if you do press it.
I'm definitely not going to ignore that run of ults and VP from Antiquarian.
No, that was mad. Absolutely mad, Antiquarian. Such a strong play. We had to completely derail our talk about the system mechanics.
I was like, wait a minute.
Pay attention to me! I'm fighting!
Yeah. I was like, wait, what did I just see? Did he just run up all DP? Yes, he did.
Yeah, right.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
All right.
Nah, you got too close for that throw.
Nice reaction, DP. That was very good.
I like that. Yeah, we got the stocks again.
Yo, Hawk Tua, all right.
It breaks me every time. I'm not going to be able to unsay it. Oh, full pickup here as well. Using that 5U charge nicely. Maybe.
I'm gonna build Beater for Super. What's the setup? Install. Oh my!
There it is again, Lucy.
So clean with it. My God! Into the Super, you're absolutely dead. Taking the lead to 4-6 now. Flower Division up 2 lives. Lucy putting in work.
Yo, man, making this Versusia look incredibly good. We've seen plenty of the character tonight, but I don't think anyone has piloted as well as Lucy so far. Just using all of the aspects of the toolkit, right? Using the 5U charges across all their special moves, either to extend their turn on offense, keep themselves safe, or using the new fob that you get once you do have that stock in place to get these long hit confirms, or again, maintain offense when it's used on block. So demonstrating what this character has to offer. Krylos will be coming up next with Belial. So we're going to see if they're going to be able to deal with this one. Now, I played a few Versusias with Belial, and as I was learning the matchup, I kind of felt it was a little stressful just to get in, because, like, you know, Versusia doesn't have, like, those projectiles and opportunities for you to throw out those 5Us at full screen, so that wasn't an element that I could really rely on for Belial. But once you get in, Versusia not having a DP outside of spending the SBA gauge does mean that you can basically just run the usual game.
Yeah, that is always a weakness, no matter which character you're on. If you don't have a mirrorless DP, it's rough.
And also the spacing traps too, because a lot of Versusia's pressures will end where she's just outside of range, so even though she's negative, you're not able to contest with, like, the correct normal, and Versusia can press, you know, one of her long range mediums to stuff you and punish counter you, or one of the close range lights, or, you know, I say close range lights, they go pretty far to contest you, trying to go for your longer but farther reaching button. So a little bit of RPS, and I feel like Belial struggles in those scenarios. But here comes the mix. We go for that backdash shimmy, no bite from Lucy. Damn, DL Psych just throwing Krylos under the bus.
I don't
like
think Krylos is one to rage quit. That probably was, I mean, maybe, but I doubt it. Krylos is a homie.
Yeah, but, you know, fighting games and ranked, they do something to people. Any given moment, you could crumble.
Like, I haven't said I haven't done it, right? I might have done it.
Yeah, exactly, before. Right? You know, I know, I appreciate you sticking up for
but
Krylos,
I don't do it in
but
ranked.
Y'all
I don't think I've ever rage quit in ranked. I've definitely done it in tournament a lot.
Well, tournament, my OP's not on that.
That's what I'm saying.
Tournament's a tournament, bro. Going for...
Yeah, we're trying to get Lucy to press. There it is.
Very nice.
Oh, drops
the wing. Simple. Yeah, I hate to see it.
Yeah, if you don't get the first light on the first frame, that combo drops, unfortunately.
Yeah. The hugest of delays. That's so scary, too.
Oh, my...
That, I like it.
Do it again. No, just another 2M.
Yeah, so good. Alternating between the options. I like how Krylaws is leaning towards these strikes, right? Keeping on that offensive pressure and saying, my throws, they're a little bit of seasoning. They're infrequent, but they're there to add that little bit of zest.
Exactly.
That's what he's good for. Plus unblock. Yo, swung. Unless, no. Dang it. That's another weird thing about Versusia, too, is that some moves, like the animations, to me, I still have trouble distinguishing them at times. So sometimes, like, wait, was that the plus on block or was that the negative space trap? You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I'm definitely not used to this character's frame data.
You got away with murder! Versusia had no sugar to give!
That's insane. Did not pay attention if Krylaws spent the meter or not, so just backed away. And now you're eating all this damage. You got reset!
Oh, the reset? I actually don't mind this from Krylaws, right? Saving the meter for another rainy day.
Oh, yeah, not gonna be able to punish that.
Rev counter.
Now all gone for Lucy. You still got these great normals, though.
Yeah, but it's the average. While pressure, we go for the shimmy yet again. Lucy recognizing the throw doesn't kill me, not yet, but the hit will.
Nice throw.
Taking that, you're bad.
Wait, that wins!
Oh god!
Lucy completes the clean sweep. Wow.
Absolutely based. Yeah,
that was sick.
I mean, it's so rare to come across a character that has a projectile invulnerable super that they can just outright kill you for throwing out those projectiles. So we forgot that aspect of the matchup. Krylaws will throw out the Goetia, throw that final round away, and Lucy completes the clean sweep. So now Rock has a decision to make in terms of who they're going to be sending in next from Flower Division.
We do have the blind picks coming in. Oh, yeah, people are coming in. I see it. We got Starlet and we got Fumbler.
Oh, Fumbler's here.
Fumbler is here. Let's go. Is Starlet on the Nier? Okay. New character choice. I like it. I remember seeing Starlet on the on the Cagliostro last time. Charlotte. So we're on the Nier now. Nier. I like it. No, we have a lot of time in here. That's like almost level 500. Wait a minute. That's a lot of time.
Yo, okay.
Might not be a secondary.
Secondary of the night, actually.
Believe in victory. They're rare to come by nowadays.
Quite true.
They're a dying species. They were hunted by Cygames.
Full pickup right here. Going to be setting up full Spanager on our stocks as well. And look at this bust out DB from Funder saying, listen, like, you don't have death after this, your punish is a triple strike. That's crazy.
I just why not throw it out? I mean, funny is, like, even if you had resources, like, characters barely get punished on Charlotta DP anyways.
True. All right, but we were able to survive most of the onslaught, but it's, again, Fumbler coming in strong with the Shining Onslaught.
Helps the combo a little.
Yeah, this is spooky. Full Love Redemption stocks, right? So ideally, Starlet would love to get rid of some of these, but instead,
it's the Fumbler experience. Just walk back, ult fire, or ult tackle.
You know, that's always the scariest thing to me, too, about Charlotta getting buffed, is that, like, Zero was already performing at, like, a world-class level with the character, and it's like, yo, no one else could really do what he was doing with the character, and now people got an easier version of the character to play that don't have to rely on Zerom's very special game sense and movement. And he's going to get better for it, too. Like, oh, God. Just out.
And we're in.
Up and swinging.
We want in.
Yeah, brave counter. Going to put death on cooldown briefly, but Starlet not really too sweating, right? They had a block for like 4 or 5 seconds. Not a big deal, but oh, no, you got thrown. Now it's time for damage.
You're dead, my God. No brave point. Fumbler taking out Starlet. I'm telling you, Fumbler never loses. I haven't seen it.
No, we have not seen it yet, but Flower Division, if they want to maintain their advantage, they're going to have to do something about Stroke the Egg Roll secret weapon.
Wait, can we see Fumbler versus Secret Sauce? I'm just saying, Fumbler is a previous champion of this. Fumbler was a part of the winning team for the first draft. And Fumbler did probably did the best on that team.
Charlotte versus Vastiva.
All right, but it's gonna be nothing coming up for Flower Division.
Believe in victory. Battle one.
And engage. Ladiva versus Charlotta. Nice use of the parry. What? Wait, you used spot dodge and got punished? Excuse me?
That's crazy. Oh, look at that. We only just got a normal hit right there.
Oh,
pick
my
up
God.
As well off of the low. And a full damage as well. This is pretty terrifying stuff.
Oh, yep.
There he
is. Did not get the spot dodge. Ooh. Dude, the lariats are so scary now. You have to guard catch them.
True, true, true. Yeah, because it took away the need to have it get a dash out first, so they buffed their base properties.
And if you block the medium lariat standing, it's an unblockable.
Mm-hmm.
Which is very funny. I don't know why they gave her that, but sure.
Hashtag she needs it.
Yeah.
Ladiva. Oh, dude! It's all the light versions, though, right? You can see that we're not getting that massive corner carry.
Yeah.
Oh, full pickup here, too.
Yeah, that's going to be a bit of damage.
Yo, the 2H fake? That's goated.
No, come on!
Oh, no!
Oh, my God. It's the fumbler effect. It's making other people fumble.
Now, the fact that Charlotta was able to land and block that way. But I guess that's why it's plus on block and just for those situations.
Okay, the scoop needs one more. Guess for game.
Yeah, it will do.
Yeah, good try to press. Okay, got a round on Fumbler. All right, 1-1. It can happen. Oh no.
Uh-oh. And yeah, we able to get a little bit more damage there since Charlotta's too heavy now. Ground bounces, but Fumbler not getting the most out of it, canceling into the Shining Onslaught instead of the Noble Strategy Shenanigans.
Delay press again, but there's the command grab. That's so much damage.
Listen, y'all, let the overhead hit you. Don't stand up the block if the throw will hit you. The overhead is just a knockdown.
But the bash.
The low is scary. The throw is scary.
All right, now you are chip point. Yeah, that is an unwinnable situation. Fumbler just gonna DP for the game, tie up the set.
Pretty brutal outcome there as Fumbler, untouchable, undeniable, simply canon.
And if it's Lupro coming up next, this will be a team fight from that first draft, as they were part of the same team. And it's going to be Lupro. Hello. All right. This will be Fumbler's last game. But can Fumbler complete another clean sweep? What is up with Charlotte? Yo, Charlotte, someone's got to do something.
I mean, between the Fairy and the Charlotta players tonight, man, like, something's crazy.
Fairy and Charlotta top one in the best of one. That'd be crazy. New top tier. We got to make a tier list based on just the results of the draft.
Oh no, you try to spot dodge that. That's not the counterplay to it. Lupro gonna get baited on the DP. Fumbler now.
Defend it.
Reading strike extension. Dope, damn it. Optimal DP punish. That's it. Uh-oh. Lupro now.
But
has
the
to fade back.
Just a neutral jump in the corner. The classic Charlotta defense.
You gotta wonder too, you know, like Lupro had that corner positioning but was not able to go into the third eye stance because Lupro had resources, has a DP as well, so you're just basically saying, please wake up reversal me if you go into that stance. So, it's pretty hard for UL to go for those options for these characters. Nice! Well, we kind of backed up though, I don't think we were expecting to hit. Might have had a ability to confirm, I'm not sure. Nah, okay, Fumbler's too good. Just unstoppable,
just
undeniable.
You're not dead yet.
I'm convinced this is just
Oh my god!
That's it. This is this Fumbler is a fictional character. This is simply a Smurf account of Zerom. Like, there's no way.
No, Fumbler is just the main character. We're just NPCs. Fumbler's just the protagonist. Yo, Yoza, I gotta ask, has Fumbler lost a singles game today? Can I ask if Fumbler's lost at all?
Anyone want a tattletale on Fumbler while they've had opportunities to play off stream?
Like, I don't believe it. I do not believe that Fumbler would ever lose. It's actually insane. It's gonna be Yozamitsu coming up.
You know Fumbler said, nah, I'd win, and he meant that shit. God, you just know. He meant that shit.
Oh, and it's gonna be Merp coming up for Flower Division. Only players left is Merp and Griminal Activity for Team Flower Division. And then, Stroke the Egg Roll, Yozamitsu and Bisou once again.
Merp had a really good showing in one of the first Paragon Line tournaments on this new patch, getting second place amongst crazy players.
Didn't Merp win?
No, I don't know about last week, but I'm thinking about 2 weeks ago where they were able to reset against, if I'm remembering this right, it was laid way back on winner's side, and like Merp deadass like revert like a 5-0'd. So, you know.
Oh, no, I think really it was Wazd. I think Merp won a Wazd.
Okay,
I remember seeing Merp win a tournament.
Yeah, it might have been a Wazd. I have to pull up their StarGG account and do that digging, but let's see here. So far, oh no, unfortunate outcome for Yozamitsu. The mash comes through, so does the Raging Strike as we went for the OS.
Excellent.
Nice. Got the TP out, no trap shenanigans. And we're taking the throw? Okay. That's crazy. I definitely thought the DP was coming out for Merp. Damn, Yozo's playing so well against this CAG neutral.
Setsuno trying to advance. Still able to kind of, you know, use the other various threats even though that fireball is
wow.
Yo, Kai Suisei asking if Merp wanted offline as well. Probably, they're definitely good enough for
I'm not sure.
Now how the hell am I gonna look up Merp? I wish there was a player search. Now I need FGCombo.com. If I have FGCombo.com with the new version for all the new games out. Simple shit.
Oh my god. Oh my god. What did I just see? There's like Alchemy. Two teleports and a throw bait or something. That was crazy. Both of these players playing at a million miles per minute. Oh no, drop!
Nah, too fast, too fast!
Oh, not like this. Oh, not like this.
Oh, this is becoming slowly a disaster. 6XL pressure swapping between the stances, so we have the Crescent Moon available to threaten.
Spot dodge,
run up throw. Ah, try to read the strike. This is massive damage. Can Merp build the SBA gauge? No, the combo limit hits. Yozamitsu.
Oh! Punish!
Oh, perfect timing on that close heavy to catch the anti-air. Yozamitsu not gonna be able to get the kill. No, wait a minute, the restamp potentially.
Not wait for reset.
Let's...
No, spot touch, get punished!
Body.
Yozamitsu just ready every time for those air DPs. My god. That was sick.
Unflippin' believable.
Yoza
and also, okay,
Mitsu.
So Akai Sensei, Suisei, you might have just given me a very fun new tool to play with this Believe in Victory. Let me pull this right up.
The anchor is here. Criminal Activity coming up for Flower Division. The Grand.
Believe in Victory. Oh hell.
The man with the Grand.
Engage. Oh hell yes! Y'all have given me. Okay, it's a start. Well, actually, if I look up.
Those Setsunas to control the neutral. Finally finds an opening in the corner. That's definitely going to be super. Oh my god! The BC bait Yozamitsu!
Oh no, it's cooking.
Yo's just like, all right, just get me the loser's finals. I'm breaking this curse. No final game, no final round. We're just getting out of here.
Oh, that's a big catch right there. Grimmel Activity being pushed to the back foot, but the 2M check is going to get them some momentum back.
Nice mid-screen combo DB there.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Oh, that 2U is crazy.
Oh, we're charging up the 5U. Oh, wow. 6M catch, but there's the DP. Oh, the fuzzy bash.
That's crazy.
Okay, nice tag.
Seems like...
Oh, no. No, no, too far, too far. Grimnel's still alive. Just needs one good hit. Oh! Nice spot dodge. Good spacing. Oh, but the fuzzy mash again!
Uh-huh.
Yozumitsu closes it out, breaks the curse. 2-0 over Flower Division. Stroke the Egg Roll moves on.